Alright guys, welcome back to Let's Play Rune Factory, a fantasy Harvest Moon. So, in the last episode, we gave away the rare Rollabooty, made a new friend, and just, in general, had a pretty fun time. In this episode, I have to admit something to you all. And that is that I actually recorded this once already. I recorded it, it appeared everything was fine, the video showed up, the audio all showed up, it all seemed to be okay. But I ended up having to replay up to this point in the game because I had hard drive failure. Well, not hard drive, but graphics card failure, I guess. And it messed up some things and apparently messed up my Audacity somehow and made it use the wrong mic even though it was saying it was using the correct mic. So it was garbled nonsense. And this is where I am now. I'm level 5. I have, you know, plus one to swordsmanship, mining, fishing, and farming, I think. So I'm a little bit ahead where I was before. And I have about 500-600 more G than I did previously. But other than that, I also found a silver. And I found that at the end of the mine. I was just mining some rocks, getting a little bit more experience right before I got to this point and got some silver. So that's lucky. Yeah, so I'm doing better on money, better on everything, not quite where I was before. I just wanted to be straight up about that. So let's get moving on to the next day. All right, so to start today off, we are going to water the crops. Water the crops in here. Dodge all the enemies. Pull out our broadsword. Take a hit because I was hoping I could take a second hit. Realize our crops are a little bit different than before. I've picked up cucumbers, cabbage, and just done all the fields here. And since we're running a little bit low on HP here, I'm going to not pull that out, instead pull out my sword. And we're going to deal with this goblin over here. This is actually a fantastic grind spot, not only for experience, but also because he drops some really good items very rarely. And like that, we've leveled up. So, full HP once again, back to watering. We're going to mine a little bit. Skill up. And beat this guy one last time, just for good measure. Now that all of our chores are taken care of. Today is Wednesday, so Sharon is unavailable until night, and we can't see her at night yet, so that's a moot point. Let's go say hello to everyone else, though. I recommend radish seeds. They'll fetch a nice price. With this, we have enough money for what I want to do today.
Come on in.
So,
thanks for coming, as always.
Let's go into a special goods section. We are going to buy a cheap bracelet. And yet another cheap bracelet. So if we equip both of these, we now get plus 6 to defense. It is fantastic because that boosts our defense up to 15. I believe at the level we were before, we had something like 6 defense originally? Or maybe 3 defense, something like that? No, it was 6, I believe. And that means it would have doubled our defense. So, you know, we're doing pretty well at that point. But we're not quite done. We're gonna be heading in here. Hey, Leo.
You got business here?
Show me what you have. And we're gonna be buying a small shield. Now, thinking about it,
you got business here?
I actually just sold all my resources. Never mind. I think I'm gonna go mining real quick, get some resources to upgrade my hammer. Because as I mentioned previously, upgrading the hammer is actually important for getting better resources as time goes on. This gives 3 defense, which boosts our defense up to 18, even higher than our attack at this point. But if we want to get the good resources, you know, higher level silver and all things like that, and get a lot of money quickly, we're going to need a better hammer. So, give me a second while I run. Actually, we're going to go say hello to everyone in town, that way I don't forget. Xavier will talk your ear off, but Tori's the opposite. Have you gotten used to living here, Raguna? What? You need a room? Yes. I was just pulling your leg, but if you want to rent a room, it'll be 10G. On second thought, maybe not. Oh well, that's too bad. Maybe next time. This town is a nice place to live, but it doesn't offer much to attract tourists. What, you need a room? No, I have a place to stay. Yeah, I know. You're going to Carmite Cave? Well, it's no concern of mine if you put yourself in danger.
Good morning.
Running a bar, I get to see many different sides to my customers' personalities. That's a lot of fun. It looks like you got a pass to Carmite Cave, hmm? While you're there, remember that our thoughts are with you. Our thoughts are always with you, you know. Please try to lead a meaningful life. It's the most important thing you can do. If you get along with your monsters, they can help out on your farm. They can also help you work the fields. Well, some at least. A lot of them don't get much work done at all. I love this town. It's charged with the Earth's vitality. I can feel it. A potion? First, I'll need 3 medicinal herbs and 400 cheese. That okay? Yes. Oops, it looks like you don't have enough ingredients. I'll need 3 medicinal herbs. Huh. I actually don't have any. Mr. Guna, I hear that you've got a pass to Carmite Cave. Please take care. There are monsters in there. I love books. When I read, it's like I travel to another world. Mr. Guna, you're suffering from amnesia, right?
Yes.
That's a common pattern in novels. How exciting, amnesia.
Apparently she is too.
Okay, we're gonna check out the field real quick. See if I have any herbs here. Might as well grab these things while I'm here. Use my axe a little bit. Alright, did not get so lucky. I'm getting really unlucky today. Yep, it does not appear we have any. And that's fine, I guess. Instead, let's hammer a little bit. Grind on this guy for a minute. I didn't realize how close we were, but we're actually about to level up after the next kill. So I'm actually just gonna risk it and get a kill here and just, you know, keep fighting, keep mining. There we go. So this guy is a goblin. Goblins, I believe I'm just going to like do a little smash cut thing kind of thing to show all the information on every enemy, but this guy can drop a few very good things, which I'll say actually in video. This guy can not only drop Camus's favorite gift, but he can drop a better sword. And even if you didn't want the sword for use right now for whatever reason, it's worth a huge amount of money for this point. So, you know, if you want a little bit of extra money at this point in the game, I'd recommend just doing this for a few minutes. Sadly, we're not actually getting any drops. And he doesn't actually deal any damage anymore to us. He deals minimum, aka 1. So we're just going to mine for a minute. Use up all of our HP. Okay, that should be good enough, one way or another. So right off the bat, I changed my mind what we're doing. We are no longer going to be upgrading our hammer. We're actually going to be upgrading our axe. It's important to get an upgraded axe earlier on just to be able to cut down those stumps. So let's take care of that real quick.
You got business here?
Yes, yes I do. Can you forge a tool for me? What do you want to forge? If you're holding that now, I can't forge that. Put it in your backpack. An axe. You want me to forge a cheap axe? It'll take 5 pieces of iron, 400 G in 2 days. Is that okay? I don't think I have enough iron. Nope. Alright, I'm 1 short. Which means we're not doing our axe. But I do want to do something. Which means I guess we're going to do our hammer. I'm a liar.
You got business here?
I think it only costs 4 for this. It'll take 4 pieces of iron, 500 G in 200 days. Just okay? Yes, okay. I want to get it done before holiday, because if I get it done before holiday, then I can have it done over holiday as well, so it'll be done Monday. It's just a good idea to make good use of your time. Alright.
Hello!
You got a pass to Carmite Cave! You're awesome, Raguna! I guess I got a pretty good judgment.
Hello!
And this is a shipping box. Da-da-da, I already read all this. Hey, you filled it up today. I think you found your calling. You're made to live off the land. Yeah. Messed everything up. Okay, I don't know what I've sold some of before, so I'll just throw everything I have in the bin here so it'll be sold tomorrow. Before we head back into the dungeon, let's heal.
Good evening.
My daddy likes to go to the men's bath. I love the bathhouse. I'm gonna swim in the big bathtub. Daddy is here too. If I played hide and seek at the bathhouse, the boys would never be able to find me.
Good evening.
The geothermal heat at Clemens Mountain has made the subterranean water scalding hot. It's too bad we can't bring books into the bath. Hello, Ragoon. I didn't expect to see you here. I've come with my daughter today. It's too bad. Yeah.
Good evening.
A nice hot soak is the best kind of medicine. It helps you unwind so you can get a good night's sleep. Oh, good to see you like baths too, Raguna. Camus comes to bathe a lot too, but I think he comes for another reason.
Accurate. So, Camus actually has the hots for Melody, which, I mean, Melody's adorable, so it makes sense.
What?
Okay, broadsword once again. She's gonna be grinding against this goblin here because I really want the sword he can drop. That, and actually, is a fantastic source of experience. Wow, I'm not getting anything as far as drops go. This is a very easy way to grind, though. He just keeps walking towards you, so if you hit him, boom, done. It only costs like 1 HP if he hits you, so to my knowledge, he doesn't have any status effects, so it's just fantastic. Oh no, he hit me for a crit that time for 12.
Yeah, skill up.
So I'm not sure I've mentioned it before, but you can actually do a charge attack with your sword. It'll let you do a wave slash, kind of like the sword beams, I think they're called, in Zelda. Level up once again. It only takes 3 slashes now. If you're lower level than me, one thing you can do, if you hit him 2 times and then don't hit him again, it won't stun him. So you just have to wait just a second and then start another combo. You can keep him kind of a stun lock like that, but it takes precise timing. I won't bother with it right here because I don't need to, but, you know, it is an option for you. Nope. I'm getting crap for drops today. Before I got, like, 5 of the warrior certificates and a sword. So this sucks. Level up! Skill up. Level up. Might not be the most entertaining way to grind, but if you're getting good drops, it's worth it. Sadly, I'm not currently, which is rather unfortunate. But, you know, normally you'd be getting good drops here. I'm just having an unlucky day, I guess. Well, unfortunately, we didn't get anything at all. That's statistically very unlikely, but I didn't get anything. So, yeah, everyone has those days, right? Alright, let's head inside. We are done with our 5th day. Or 4th day. Whoops. I always get confused when it's after midnight. Probably because I'm, you know, running off of less than 5 hours sleep per night, or just over 5 hours sleep per night. Alright. Back to farming. Oh! right, today's the 5th, which means we actually have some radishes done. That little blue circle you see on the screen is actually called a rune. They are the source of rune points throughout the game, and they are worth 25 rune points whenever you pick them up. My biggest recommendation, start a rune farm. Start farming them, just create a bunch of crops throughout that are just easy to grow and you don't care about, and you'll have infinite energy. I've only used 20 points thus far, so I won't even bother grabbing that, but after we're farming in the cave, I'll take care of that. Tomorrow is the day where most of our stuff in the caves as well as on the farm should be done. So you'll be seeing all of these different patches have individual rune points. Except for the strawberries that I planted down there, but you know, strawberries take 8 days, which means they'll be ready on the 9th. No, 10th. 10th, right. Okay. At this point, just pull out your sword, kill this thing before it has a chance of doing anything bad to you. Or, oh, I actually did it. And that was apparently a level up. Okay, best level up, I don't know what you're talking about. And a skill up in farming. So recently I've really been craving playing Rune Factory, even when I don't have the time to actually record. So I've been starting again Rune Factory 2 once again, which, a bit of a spoiler for that game, I've never actually technically beaten it. I've gotten to the end of the game, something happened, and I didn't want to put another, like, 3 hours into the game just to be able to finish it, so I left it there. So I decided, at some point I'll probably do some, you know, a let's play for the game, so I might as well practice a bit now, do another practice right before I play the game, and, you know, it'll be good. The biggest change that I cannot get over how good it is the fact that you don't waste water if you misclick. Yes, you'll still use a little bit of energy, but you don't use the water in your watering can if it's not on a tilled soil square that hasn't been watered. And that is the best thing, because this game, if you mess up, then you have to make another trip over the water, and it's just awful. Alright, now that we're out here, grab that so that we have a bit of energy, a bit of rune points, and let's go say hi to Sharon. I figure I want to talk to everyone every day, I want to be able to give gifts to people, and starting tomorrow, we can actually... I guess we can't do most of that, so never mind. Ignore me for now. There's something that draws you into the caves. I know all about it. Do you now? Wow, our skills are really starting to come along. Alright, while we come in here, before we even bother talking to him, let's give him a gift. A warrior certificate? Thanks, I love these!
Come on in.
Come on in, Raguna. I don't think that'll be enough, but let's check. Nope. The people of this town are all wonderful people. I only eat 2 meals a day, but Daddy has 7. Oh. Hey, May. I actually came over here to grab a fish so I could show something off, and May's just standing here looking out all dramatically, so... good timing, I guess? You caught a sardine. I actually want to catch a fish just so I could show this off. If you give this to May... Thanks, I love the sardine. Knowing my taste is one of your good points. She loves fish. So, you know, give them. I like being alone. Okay. If you want May to like you, just be friends and all that, or if you try to romance her, give her fish daily. Higher level fish are better, and to marry her, you actually have to be able to trade someone, just warning you now. So, be careful if you're aiming to marry her. Either buy a second copy of the game or have a friend who has it, because... otherwise, you can't marry her. Oh, right. I never finished watering over here. Hey, Xavier. Today's your lucky day. Why don't I share some special tips with you about staying alive in caves? About a mysterious noise. Listen, if you ever hear a weird beeping kind of noise in a cave, you better watch out. That's the sound you start to hear when your HP gets low. Sometimes while exploring and digging, you might let your HP drop to 0 before you notice. Getting killed by a monster could be considered an honor for an explorer, but death by digging? That's lame. So watch out for that beeping noise. About fields and caves. When it comes to exploring caves, the most important thing is the ground. How come the ground is so important? Don't you know anything? Listen, whether we're using swords or hoes, we use RP. In other words, rune points. When you run out of RP, you can't use magic. You can use the sword, but when you use one without RP, you start losing HP, health points. In caves, running out of HP means death, you know. So you have to think about replenishing your RP as you go along. That's why fields are so important. Are you with me? Runes are a crystallized form of the power of the earth. And the power of the earth grows crops. In my experience, you can get one rune for every 9 crops you have. If you take the runes, they'll be gone for the time being, but there'll be more of them the next morning. So if you plow fields and grow crops inside there, here and there, inside caves, you can replenish your RP at each place. This is the most basic stuff. If you're gonna explore caves, you have to know at least this much. Thanks, but no thank you. I see. Best of luck to you then. Well, let's do a little bit more combat today. Actually, looking at it, I might be able to take on this dungeon. I'll take on the dungeon tomorrow. Tomorrow we're gonna finish this dungeon. That's something I can promise, but I might as well show how easy it is to do this. Once you're this level, it's just easy. You can beat this level not easily, but with a little bit of skill at level 8. I am currently level 13, so I'm a little bit overleveled, and that's fine. That's okay. Everything's good. Okay, we're just gonna grind on this enemy a bit more because I'm still trying to get the sword to drop. Either that or more items to gift Camus. More items to gift Camus, okay? Yeah, okay, good timing. Right as I say it, level up. We're getting to the point where this is a diminishing return, so I'm not gonna level up again before I run out of HP, more than likely. But I can always, you know, hit up the bathhouse, so that's not really a problem. You know, I'm kind of determined, so I might end up doing the cave today. We can still hit up the bathhouse to get 4 RP. I normally like having a potion. So what I'll do is I'll head further into the dungeon here. Did I just... Right as I was giving up. Right as I was giving up. Okay, we got a longsword, level 2, 11 attack. The sword's long blade keeps enemies at bay but takes skill to use. It is a one-handed sword, which is the same kind we use. It is just an upgrade, and is this thing will sell for as much as it will you can buy it for in the store after beating this cave. It is a really good item to get. And I just seriously got it right when I was giving up. Alright, that's hilarious to me, actually. So, I'm going to hope I can find a few medicinal herbs in here. If I can't, I might just say, oh well. And that'll be fine. But at least we're getting to, you know, show everything off here. Get our swordsmanship up a little bit while clearing this field. That is so dumb, and it makes me so happy. Okay, how many antidotal herbs do I have? I only have 2. Which means this is the end of the line because I want to keep one extra, just in case. Miss Melody and I are friends. Thank you, I love it when people come and take a bath here. That'll be 10G, thanks. Okay, so there's one enemy here. This will just be a basic orc. Orcs. A weak enemy with 33 HP, 26 attack, and 4 defense. They use earth-based attacks and have a chance to crit. They drop cheap cloth and broadswords. If you tame one, then they'll harvest crops for you. Then there's an orc archer. Orc archers. HP 26, attack 22, defense 3. Their attacks can cause seal. They drop cheap cloth and arrowheads. If you tame one, then they can harvest crops for you. Level up already. Any names I say in this video are not final. Future Gabe knows everything based on lists and things, so I could misremember names, so take everything I say with a tiny grain of salt. Trust him, he's better at this than I am. Goblins. HP 39, attack 36, defense 5. They use fire-based attacks and can land criticals. Their drops are warrior certificates, gunpowder, and longswords. And if you tame one, they can harvest crops for you. Alright. No drop there, that would have been hilarious though. So if you come down here, there's an ant spawner that can seal you. Be very careful.
Ants, HP 28, attack 22, defense 4. They can seal your skills, absorb your HP, and land critical hits. They dropped insect skins, insect jaws, and wet grass seeds. If you tame one, they can harvest crops for you.
I'm having no trouble clearing these, but I would be very careful if I were you, because you're probably not as high level as I am, and that's fine. You don't need to be this high level.
Hornets. HP 30, attack 27, defense 5. Their attacks are poisonous and they can land critical hits. They drop insect skin, wind crystals, and bandanas. If you tame one, they'll produce honey daily for you.
We got a wind crystal. That is fantastic for multiple reasons. Oh. Okay. Real quick. This wind crystal is level 2, so it's worth 320. You could do one of two things with those wind crystals they drop. Well, three things, I guess. You can sell them for money, which makes sense. You can give them to Sharon, which is a really good gift for her. She loves all the crystals except for Earth, I believe. Or you can use them in crafting, which you can't do until way later in the game, but it's fine. Hey, a door! So, there's a squirrel in here.
Chorori, also known as Chip Squeak in later games. HP 30, attack 24, defense 3. Their attacks will topple you, knocking you over. They can drop skin and fire crystals. If you tame one, they're useless, but are adorable.
It's not a honestly, the squirrel enemies aren't a threat unless you're careless. I believe they're the first enemy who can actually knock you down and just start beating on you. So be very careful of them. But, you know, if you dodge out of the way of their hits, they're really not a problem. They are very predictable how they move. Okay, antidotal herb. Let's try this.
Goblin Archer, HP 32, attack 28, defense 3. Their attacks inflict paralysis. They can drop cheap bandage, gunpowder, and silver rings. If you tame one, they'll harvest crops for you.
There we go. Alright, let's save. Alright, let's do this. What's behind that door? Hey, Raguna, you came too? You know, Raguna, something's fishy about this room. I've been searching this cave, and I get the feeling that door opened if we can break those weird thingamaboppers. Call it a treasure hunter's hunch. Sounds like it's worth a try. Hey, Raguna, did you know those thingamabobbers regenerate each time you leave the cave? Really? Yeah, so if you plan on destroying all of them, you have to stay in the cave until the job's done. But my strength might not hold out that long. That's what sleeping bags are for. You do have a sleeping bag, don't you, Raguna? Actually. What? Are you out of your mind? You need a sleeping bag while exploring caves. Well, since you obviously are clueless, I'll give you mine. Here, take it. No, that's alright. Hey, don't tell me you're thinking of borrowing Miss sleeping bag. Why wouldn't it give to be able to sleep in the... But never you mind that. Look, I said I'm gonna give you this, so I'm gonna give it you it. You got a cheap sleeping bag. You can use your sleeping bag to sleep in caves and recover HP, but your RP won't recover much. To do that, you'll have to plant crops in fields that you find inside caves. When the crops ripen, you can receive rune points. It's important to plant crops even in caves. Got it. Now then, getting back to what's on the other side of that door. You know, that door didn't used to be there. Clearly someone must have built it. I don't like the looks of this. Sometimes it takes courage to flee, too. A real treasure hunter knows when it's time to stay and when it's time to scram. And now is definitely time to scram. Peace out. So, let's let this enemy spawn real quick. Another goblin. I was really hoping it would drop something. And that is the final one. So we're gonna go take on the boss. As he said, you just have to break each of them, and we got a sleeping bag out of the deal. This is the cheap sleeping bag, used for sleeping outdoors. It's ragged and worn, so you might not sleep well. You get... I'm gonna have Future Gate put it up on screen, but I think it's like 10 RP and 100 HP or something.
Womp.
Back every time you sleep, it costs you the day. It's like sleeping in a normal bed, but not as good. But on the bright side, nothing in the cave will respawn. So if you know that it's gonna take a couple days to beat a boss, or finish a dungeon, or do something, do it. Have fun. Whoa. What is that? A Greater Daemon? Here? Also, don't at me on the whole Daemon thing. I say Daemon, some people just say Demon because they have the same meaning, but I say Daemon because I like that. Mist, what are you doing here? I couldn't find you on the farm, so I thought I'd look for you here. I can't believe such a huge monster is here. And look at it, it's frightened.
Frightened?
Sure, it was probably brought here against its will. Raguna, use your powers to send it back to its world.
You mean if I defeat in battle, I can use the power of Retorting to send it back?
That's right.
Okay, I'll see what I can do. You best stand back, though, Mist. This might get messy.
Okay, just please be careful.
I will.
So this is the Greater Daemon, the first boss, the boss of Carmite Cave.
Greater Daemon, HP 250, Defense 3. Magic Defense 17, Elemental Defense 30. He has 4 different attacks he can use. He can punch, he can charge at you, he can use a stone spike, and during the critical phase, he'll charge 3 times in a row at you. He has no drops, and you cannot tame him. You should focus on attacking during the windup for his attacks, and then dodge otherwise.
He has some pretty basic attacks. Time does not pass when you're in boss battles, which is very nice. So when he's doing this thing, he's charging forward. Be very careful. Get 2 or 3 hits in whenever he does that. And he'll do a stalactite attack whenever you do that. Alright, I already have him in red. Ow. Yeah, this is easy considering our level. And we've already leveled up because we beat him. So, you're supposed to be around level 8, I'd suggest, to beat him. I'm way over-leveled, and that's fine. It didn't need to be a challenge, let's be honest. Raguna, you're alright.
I survived.
You're amazing, Raguna. I bet you're really a legendary warrior, or a knight in the Holy Order.
Do you really think so? Or do you really think I'm not just somebody who ground for 2 days straight to get to the point where he could demolish a Greater Daemon with a single sword that he stole from a goblin?
What? No! Well, since we still don't know your past, you ought to think big. Any rate, I was able to save the Oh, right. Yeah, this shouldn't be missed. This is Raguna. Any rate, I was able to save the Greater Daemon's soul. I'm so happy! I wonder what he was doing here in the first place.
I have no idea, but I wonder.
Wonder what?
Maybe it has something to do with those strange devices I found inside the cave.
But I have no idea who could have put them there, and why.
I see.
In any case, there's not much we can do but wait to see what happens.
Right.
Well, I guess I'll head on back now. Bye!
So we're done with Carmite. Technically, we never have to come back here. There's an optional event that will happen here during the summer, but once again, optional event. We will, of course, be coming back here because we have all these crops to do and, you know, mining and everything else, but we are officially done. Just gonna clear the field here. I have a lot of extra energy, so I wanna see. Does using this axe, which can't break these stumps, actually level it up? Okay, so we're logging. We're about to be level 2. So you can get your skill up even though you can't break this. And as such, I know what I'm doing for the rest of the day. And now we're down to 1 HP. So, we're done for the day. Alright guys, next time on Let's Play Rune Factory, A Fantasy Harvest Moon. We're going to be finishing off today
and going into the next day. Our crops should be ready. We'll have plenty of rune points from here on out. So see you all next time. Bye.